kind of like a dream trip. Like, it's, you know, it's not something everyone can afford to do, and it's because of snowboarding and because of what we do that we could afford to do that or have the connections to allow us to do that. But definitely the trip of a lifetime. The whole thing is just like mind-blowing. The whole Mike Wigley's experience, it's totally like a TV show. It doesn't feel real.
After we would get picked up from our house and brought right up to the top of the mountain.
Spotted out this one from the sky. It kind of looked like it's maybe like 40, 50 feet. So I got to the top of my cliff and started throwing some snowballs. I was like, all right, Mike, like, is that where I want to land?
It was so big, and it was funny because he didn't even look at it. He couldn't, it was an overhanging cornice and he couldn't spot the landing. So we were just communicating with the guide and asking him if that's a good direction.
Pretty crazy, but like, that's where you want to go. And I was like, okay, sweet, yeah. As soon as I creeped off the thing and started spinning, I was like, okay, this thing, it was just like, definitely the longest free fall of my life.
And it was huge, too bad he didn't land that one.
Next year, I'd like to go back and maybe scope it out, because it's a pretty legendary cliff.
The rain was endless, the mountains are so big, and the places you can go, it's endless.